Batman the Imposter Part 1, written by Mattson Tomlin, who is also the screenwriter for Matt Reeves' The Batman. So you might expect some similarities. This is from DC Black Label, which means this is a non-canon storyline. Our story starts with Dr. Leslie Tompkins waking up in the middle of the night and saw Batman badly injured. She took his mask off and finds out that he's Bruce Wayne. She was tempted to call the EMTs and the police, but figured he'd just ended on Arkham. But she knew his history. For those who don't know her, Dr. Leslie Tompkins is a close friend and medical colleague of Thomas Wayne. Leslie serves as a surrogate parent to his son Bruce after his parents are murdered, and later becomes an ally in his crusade as Batman. Then we get a glimpse of Bruce Wayne's childhood, such as the murder of his parents, suffering from PTSD, and growing up with that kind of rage. When he woke up, Leslie offered him psychiatric help and told him that she will reveal that he's Batman if Bruce won't tell her what happened. Bruce told Leslie he was stopping a robbery that night, but one of the store owners was shot at the shoulder. The robber grabbed another hostage. Batman threw his batarang but slightly missed his target. Now this is a relatively new Batman, so it makes sense for him to be sloppy. The robber fired at him and Batman took some of it. Eventually, Batman took them down, but he lost consciousness on the way back due to his bleeding, and after that, he ditched the bike. Leslie began questioning Bruce's transformation, but Bruce just told him that becoming the Batman is not some kind of unfortunate effects of his childhood trauma, but it is his vow. Leslie threatened Bruce again to convince her of his activities or she will reveal his identity. Bruce just answered that he's making a difference. He added that last week is the first night in Gotham with zero violent crimes in 54 years, which is not because of the police, the mayor, or the DA, but it's because of him. Then Leslie told him to sign some kind of contract that says he's a patient and legally protects their conversations to avoid breaking confidentiality. So they have an agreement that Bruce will need to come to her office every morning at dawn to talk about his activities. If he won't show up, she'll call the police. Now we switch over to Detective Blair Wong, investigating in a hotel where they suspect that the Batman disguised himself as one of the construction workers and they found some zip lines from the building. Next, a wealthy, powerful businessman named Mr. Wesker asked Detective Wong about the status of their investigation on the Batman. Mr. Wesker told her that the Batman's previous antics is bad for their business and may lose contact with the Sionis family, a mafia group led by Roman Sionis, aka Black Mask. Mr. Wesker warned her that in the long run, the people with power will do something about the Batman. Eventually, the investigation team expanded to aid Detective Wong on her investigation of the Batman. Wong started with her clues, such as the Batman is a male, somewhere between 20 to 40, fair complexion with possible military training, and an access to wealth. Next, they saw a footage of seemingly the Batman killing three of blindfolded and tied criminals by kicking them off the rooftop. Wong asked the captain of the source of the video, and then the captain just replied that it was from a private network where Wesker Capital offered up the footage. We also learn here that Gordon in this story is already assisting the Batman's crusade. What is cool about this is Wong's collected ideas and theories about the Batman, about him arriving at Gotham 3 years ago. For about 6 months, the GCPD has been receiving calls about a flying vampire. Criminals thought of him as an invincible creature, where he stood back up after being shot, and him disappearing and appearing on the other side of the city impossibly fast. Her assumption was he's heavily armored, multiple complaints of zip lines popping up across the city, flying through the air and discovering a dozen of impounded motorcycles, which are not abandoned, but hidden across the city. Since it is in full tank and tires are not flat, him popping up so fast across the city must be from the network of bikes with him, going to hidden routes, and also the bikes are expensive, which means the Batman is wealthy. Next, Batman appeared to Leslie right before sunrise, and telling her that there is an imposter pretending to be him. Then we switch over to Batman confronting to Otis Flanagan, aka Ratcatcher. He told him that he knew about his tunnels and bikes, but promises to keep it a secret. He also suggested him about other forgotten secret tunnels to help him. Getting back to Wong on her investigation, she thought that the victims did not have anything related except that they were all criminals. She even thought that there is a personal vendetta on this matter. Since there are a lot of wealthy personalities in Gotham, she started asking Bruce Wayne to talk about the Batman. Well, that's it for today's episode. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.